Welcome back to the channel, guys. My name is Joseph, and today I want to talk about Chivalry 2. Now, I'm all about on this channel about trying out different kinds of games that provide different kinds of experiences. So what is Chivalry? Where does it fall? Well, it's a 64 multiplayer medieval game that primarily focuses on melee combat. There are archers, of course, and they provide a very necessary support role, but they're not as much fun as any of the other three classes, which in themselves have various versions with their own special abilities like healing your allies or throwing firebombs. And honestly, I opted to be the healer since I wasn't much of a fighter in this game. It's quite difficult actually to master and understand all the mechanics, which are so different from other multiplayer games. You can play either in first person or third person mode, and you feel more in control of your moves, of course, in first person because you can kind of see an animation. But I've mainly played in third person because I just like seeing my knight run into battle or cheer on for a chant of a battle cry as he runs into battle. It just completely gets me into the mood. On the surface, this game seems simple with just three button attacks. You got a horizontal slice, vertical overhead slice, or a poke or a stab, which can be chained into combos, but quickly you realize its complexity with the inclusion of dodging, faking, blocking skills, where you have to match your enemy's side to successfully parry or riposte. Mix in the chaos of 64 players and objectives of escorting battering rams and storming castles and setting explosives all over the map, you start to get an idea how crazy it all can get. Not to mention, you can keep fighting even if the enemy chops your arm off, which automatically reminded me of Monty Python. There's a silly sense of humor mixed in with an authentic medieval combat. In the full game, you shall be able to customize your knight fully, from their look to their armor, emotes, and many of which are quite hilarious. And in the beta, I got to check out, they give you a chance to play with two different modes, whether it be team deathmatch or objective-based mode, where you can have either defend the castle or have to storm one. This is the mode I mostly stuck to and replayed because I was replaying all these movies about history that I've seen over the years as a kid, and this became like a total wish fulfillment for me to take on the role of a knight and storm a castle. And there's something so epic about escorting a siege tower and climbing over the castle walls to be met with a bunch of angry players all ready to chop at your limbs. I have played meta games in this sort of genre before with a Mordhau on PC or For Honor, but this game is simpler to play, but just as hard to master as those two other games. But it has a lot of very refined gameplay mechanics. And honestly, I thought it was more fun than Mordhau and For Honor, to be honest. As I understand, Chivalry is the original game which started this whole melee combat multiplayer thing, which started as a Half-Life 2 mod, and is the predecessor to all these other games. Not to mention, it looks quite nice running on the PlayStation 5 at 60 frames per second. I didn't have a hitch at all. Some visual glitches because it is a closed beta, and some visual glitches like my camera would automatically turn at the beginning of battle when your NPC character is giving you a speech. I was never able to look at them as it would just kind of pan off into the side. But it looks good on the Unreal 4 engine. And the four maps across two different modes I got to play actually got me excited about a game that I didn't even know was coming. And it's actually going to be released on June 8th, right around the corner. And I'm officially excited to jump into some melee combat just because it gives you something different. I put over 300 hours into For Honor, and as satisfying as that combat was in that game, it was very snappy. Chivalry makes it up for its lack of flash that For Honor had. It makes it up with authenticity, scale, and focus in its objective-based matches, which For Honor totally lacked. It does look like a game that will have microtransactions, and I'm basing that because the game has listed as in-game purchases based on the PSN information about it, as well as you're earning gold within the game. So I assume some sort of in-game purchases, whether it just be cosmetic only, there's some kind of currency that you have to buy, something within it is going to involve some sort of microtransactions. But honestly, it doesn't really bother me personally because I'm not very impulsive. I don't jump on those things. And if I want to pay 10 bucks for an outfit, I'll pay 10 bucks for an outfit. But the game will be released on PlayStation 4 and 5, Xbox One and Series X, as well as the Epic Store on PC. And guys, stay tuned if you want to see me stream some of the gameplay in the coming days, as the beta is going to last for a couple more days out here. And if you enjoy jumping on yourself, I think it's going to be an interesting title. It's going to be at $50 or $49.99 in the United States. I don't know how it converts into the EU or the other regions of the world, but it does look like an interesting title. That's something different from a smaller team that was crowdfunded. So it kind of all comes together into something kind of a unique experience. I would love to hear from you guys if you've played other melee-based multiplayer games, or you've played the first Chivalry and what you thought of it, and maybe what I've gotten wrong in my description of it. But so far, I loved it. And I'll probably leave maybe a little bit more of the gameplay for you guys so you can kind of check it out. Other than that, guys, peace out. Enjoy the rest of your day.